Magnus Aleksander Wierzejski, Marysia Kondzielska, who is host for Poland Daily Culture. Well, you know, vacation time. So someone has to carry on. Now, very exciting series of episodes about Poland and Indonesia. Poland and Indonesia actually celebrate 65th anniversary of establishing mutual relations. With me in the studio is Madame Siti Maludia, Indonesian ambassador to Poland. Ma'am, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And this is great to having you here. Let us start. How long you are in Poland?
This month, actually, a year and 3 months. So not that long, but yeah, it's 1 year and 3 months already.
And this is your another step in diplomatic career. Could you introduce us to your CV, sort of?
Sure. Yes, this is, you know, as a diplomat, being an ambassador is the ultimate career, right? And so, yes, this is my first time being the ambassador. My first posting actually in Singapore. And then the second posting abroad is in Rome, just, you know, close by. And then after that, after I spent some time in Jakarta, I was appointed as the Consul General of Indonesia in Shanghai, in China. And from Shanghai, I was transferred here as an ambassador. So yes, this is an exciting moment for me because, you know, being an ambassador for a diplomat is... it's really something.
Right. This is an important job. You can finally visit all those diplomatic meetings and, well, basically work for your country and for mutual benefit of the host country.
Of course. Yeah,
let us start from this very exciting time of the 65th anniversary of Polish-Indonesian relationships. How do you... embassy is prepared for that? What will be the celebrations like?
65th is not a common number. It's really special number. So we prepared a lot of activities to celebrate this anniversary. But unfortunately, the plan to have a really big celebration in 6 different cities in Poland, but because of COVID, we have to tone it down. So we still have we are still going to have a celebration of anniversary whole year long, but and especially on 1 week in August, which is on the 23rd to 28th of August, we are going to have the Indonesia Week. And we are going to have it in 6 cities. Beside Warsaw, we are going to have it in Krakow, Wrocław, Poznan, Torun, and Swoop. As I mentioned earlier, because we cannot be doing something physically because of the, you know, of the restriction to have people in, you know, big people in gathering more people, then we are having it more virtually through our social media and social media of these patronage cities and provinces, as well as through the electronic and printed media. So, you know, I'm really glad that Republika TV is also coming along to the celebration of the 65th anniversary of diplomatic relation between Indonesia and Poland.
Well, of course, this is a friendly nation, and we support
so
our cooperation as much as we could. I've heard there will be some concerts of the Indonesian music. What kind of music is this?
Well, the concert mainly will be done virtually. We have a traditional instrument of Indonesia here in Poland, in Warsaw. It's called gamelan. We are going to have this concert of gamelan in virtually. We are going to shoot it actually tomorrow, and so that we could have this ready by the time of the Indonesia Week. So this is traditional Indonesian music concert.
Okay.
It's called gamelan.
Indonesian musical instrument and obviously
yes.
A player.
You know, funny, because the players, not all of them are Indonesian. Some of them even Polish. The head of the group is actually Polish. He married an Indonesian. He was participated in Indonesian scholarship, cultural scholarship. And when he came back here, he was so passionate about traditional instrument gamelan. So he formed a group which called Warsaw Gamelan Group. Some of them are Polish, some are maybe 50-50 are Indonesian.
So there are people fascinated with the culture of your country, and they're actually promoting it over here. So
yes, they've been really helpful. You know, they're the true actually diplomats or ambassadors of Indonesia, because you know Polish who are playing Indonesian traditional instrument are really awesome. So I'm really thankful for them.
Right. I also heard about the cooking contest.
Oh, yes. It's not cooking contest, actually. It's a cushion, a fusion of Indonesian and Polish cuisine. The competition is to make a recipe of the mixed Indonesian and Polish cuisine. So it's very interesting because we have 60 entries, quite a lot for this kind of competition.
Something like pierogi stuffed with mango fruits.
No, pierogi stuffed with rendang. Rendang is the we call it like traditional goulash of beef goulash of Indonesia. So it's stuffed in pierogi. Or also we have kowapki stuffed with nasi goreng. Nasi goreng is fried rice. So it's really interesting. We haven't had the winner. We are going to have it in 2 days' time. Who is going to be the winner?
So no, we still don't know.
No, yeah, at the moment, no.
Okay, but we can tell what are the criteria to select the winner.
Well, of course, first is originality, and second, creativity, how they combine these two famous cuisine of Indonesia and Polish, as well as the taste, the ingredients. We have to make sure that the ingredients are really Polish combined with Indonesian ingredients, as well as the taste. The taste has to be acceptable for the Polish palates.
Ours is like less accommodating for a hot fruit than Indonesia.
Exactly, yes. Yeah. No, yeah. I think a lot of Polish people, they cannot really take spicy food, while most of Indonesian love, spicy food. Yeah. So, yes,
this
that's also
to
have to be considered. Sorry?
This is due to the climate, right? We are the middle climate, rather cold.
I guess so, yeah.
And you have this fantastic Pacific tropics.
Tropical, tropics, yes.
Summertime, all the time.
All the time, yeah. We only have, our season is hot or very hot.
Let us say a few words about the Indonesian food, since we are at this. What is the staple food? Like what the Indonesians eat every day
rice,
in the morning?
Mm-hmm. But in front of us is actually we have traditional Indonesian food. Can I explain about this food? We call it nasi tumpeng here. We have this rice, in yellow rice. We cook it with turmeric, so that's why it's yellow, shaped like this. It has a meaning actually. This kind of food is actually prepared to celebrate something. This is a show of thankful to the God of something that we achieve, or like anniversary or birthday, something like that. And it has meaning.
I'm sure we will talk more about the Indonesian food in our series, but right now our time is up.
Ah, okay. So, next time then.
Yeah, this is the first episode that I have an honor to host in place of Maria Kondzielska, but Indonesian ambassador to Poland, Madame Siti Maluda, is here in person.
Thank you very much for this
participation, and please watch us tomorrow, same time, because we have lots of interesting things to tell in Poland Daily Culture.